Hi, I'm Gunnar Peterson, and this is the Accelerated Workout. You're going to work your entire body head to toe, hitting muscles you didn't even know you had. You're going to feel better and look better by the end of it. You're already working, bouncing on the ball. It's called active sitting, engaging the core musculature, not to mention the muscles that surround the lower back and protect your spine, keeping you upright, long, and lean. Slow it down. Easy. Working into some nice, even circles. Send it to one side. Bring it around. Circle inside a square. Hit every corner on that square. Make sure you keep breathing, let the hips go, loosen them up. Get used to feeling that ball. It's an unstable surface, different from anything you've been on before. Back to center, send it in the other direction. Hit those circles, abs in. Steady breathing into a three count from the nose. Take it all the way down so your muscles can use that air. Steady exhale to a three count. Back to center, upright. Weight is centered over the ball. You're gonna send it side to side. Just preparing yourself for some of the moves we're going to do on the ball. So if the ball starts to roll, you'll know how to steady it. Back to center. You're going to rock it forward, abs pulling in, and back. Forward and back. Don't phone these in, people. These will serve you in the long run. Abs tighten and send it back. Now we're going to incorporate a little balance move here. It's a march, but I want you to start by just lifting one foot. Easy, put it down. Then the other one lifts. If this is too challenging right out of the gate, Michelle to my right here is going to modify it by keeping her hands either on the ball or not lifting the foot entirely off the ground and just doing a toe tap. From here, bring the hands up centered. Look, Ma, no hands. Keep it steady. Add a press to it once you're comfortable. Breathing, this will elevate your core temperature. Bring your heart rate up. You're starting to work. Breathing. Breathing's the key. I'll remind you. Now bring it down. Shake them out. Blood to the fingertips. Bring one hand up and across your chest. Center your weight over the ball. Pull it in tight. Nice stretch across the upper back, rear part of the shoulder. Take the arm up and over. Drive it back. Abs are in. You're still working them. Up and down behind you. Arm nice and tight to the head. Feel the stretch. Long bodies, lean bodies. Bring it forward, switch them. One arm pulls tight to you. Drive it up and over. Make it active. Over and down. Perfect, reach them up nice and high. One hand grabs the other. Your bottom hand is your pull hand. Lean it off to the side. While we're down here, let me tell you, Tracy's to my left, Anita's behind her, Madison's in the back, and Michelle, as you know, is modifying everything to the right. Bring it up to center, other side, switch to pull hand. You wouldn't believe how hard these ladies are working, and I know you're doing the same at home. Bring it up to center, reach it back. Nice long stretch down the abdominal wall. Controlled, easy, coming down, stretching out the hamstring, one leg comes out, rock it back, ease your chest down comfortably to the quad. Still nice and steady with the breathing. Lower the toe, don't drop it. Longer the leg, the better stretch. I want you to only go down as you can comfortably. Perfect, switch it other side. Leg comes out, you're on the heel, rocking back. Lower the toe, keep it long. Careful, there's no death grip on the legs. Let that go, that's wasted energy and a co-contraction. Bring it to center, feet about shoulder width apart, drop them, coming all the way down. Hands come in between the ball and the calves. Give yourself a nice big squeeze. Inhale. Slowly exhale, curl it up. Return to that bounce. It's active, not passive. Let's get ready to do this. Our first move here is going to be a little peripheral heart action, sending the blood north and south and then right back up again. So I need you to stand up, reach around, grab the ball. Keeping it about chest height, you're gonna lower into a squat, tag the ground, come up, nice strong press to the top. Keep your weight centered over your heels, release at the hip as you drop down, and strong on the press up. Here we go, do them with me. You're breathing. Long at the top, nice stretch. two times. Perfect. Bring it down chest tight. You should feel the heart rate up. You should feel your breathing increase. That's what we're looking to do here. Now we're going to do a modified squat. It's a staggered squat, so step back. You want your feet, if you're on a clock, 12 o'clock being straight ahead. You want to be at about 10 and 5. That's what you're thinking here. You're going to lower the body, the ball down. You're going to keep the ball up over your head. Chest is up, chin is up. As you go down, your heel on the back foot will come up. That's totally fine. Michelle's going to do a modified version of this by keeping the ball at your chest. You're going to do 8. This is what they look like. Jump in right now. Keep that ball up overhead. Working the core musculature, muscles that support your spine. This is key in injury prevention. Last time. Perfect switch him. You're going to 2 and 7 o'clock. Chest up, chin up, abs in. Ease it at the hips. Here we go. Back foot will come up. That's totally fine. That's what I expect. You're breathing. Perfect. Bringing it down, ball comes right in front of you. You're onto your knees. Drop your shoulders, collect yourself, find your breathing. Now we're really gonna put this ball to use by stabilizing the core. You're gonna get some shoulder stabilization work here as well, not to mention what it does for the rest of the body. Hands are gonna go outside, you're gonna do a push-up on the ball. Knees are down, you'll lower your chest to the ball and drive back up, actively pressing on the ball. The modification on this would be to keep your hips back slightly so you're lowering this way. That's what Michelle's gonna do. Follow along with her so you feel like you can work your way up to where we are. Chest up, chin up. The key is having the right form on this. That's what I'm looking for. Let's do them. Active press on the way up. Body travels in a line. Take the hips with you unless you're doing the modified version. And if you really feel up to it, you can come up on your toes, like that. And bring it back down. Perfect. Now we're gonna do an ab move, a core move. Taking the hands on the ball, roll it out slightly, let the weight drop, commit to it. So you're already working the stabilization. Just by holding this ball there, you're gonna make the muscles fire in ways they've never fired before. The more they have to adapt to something new, the more they have to change. So you'll roll out this way, and then pull back in by hollowing out at the abs. Modification on this would be to keep the arms out a little further forward when you start. Here we go, do them with me. Abs in, abs in. It's controlled out, strong pull up. Breathing. A lot of work here. I know you're doing them. Last two, finish strong. Perfect, take a rest, drop your shoulders, big inhale, big exhale, we're moving on. I need you to come up and around that ball seated. Find your balance, find your position. Remember, it's a dynamic surface working. That's why it's so much better than working on a hard surface. Reach down and grab the dumbbells. I promised you we'd use them. You're gonna lower your body now, chest down to your thighs, hands alongside, and you're gonna do a row. But we're gonna change the row a little by doing it in an alternating fashion so you get just that much more core work out of it. So it's gonna row up one side, then down, then row up the other side and down. Elbows are gonna stay tight to your body. Pull them in towards the center as you go. Here we go, do them with me. Nice even breathing into through the nose to a 3 count. Out from the mouth, same 3 count. You're in control. Don't waste any energy squeezing those handles. I want you to save it all for the lats, the big muscles across the back. Last four. Perfect, bring it up. Take a second, find your breathing. Get used to being on the ball. Now we're gonna do a modified Olympic move here. It's a clean and jerk. What it actually looks like is a pull and then a press. You're gonna bring your body back down to where you were on the row, like this. Palms back, chest down, and you're gonna clean the weight up and then press it to the ceiling. Then down and then over and return it to the starting position. What I don't wanna see is coming out this way and back and up. That puts you at a huge disadvantage from a leverage standpoint, not to mention puts you in a place to injure your shoulder, which we don't want. Here we go, do these with me, nice and easy. Up, press, perfect. Up, press, getting a lot of core work. Remember to control the weights as you put them down. You're lowering them to the floor. They're not taking you down, you're setting them down. Control the ball, a lot of different muscle firing patterns now by being on this surface while doing this move. Take advantage of it. Last one. Perfect. And down. Leave one dumbbell on the floor. Take the other dumbbell with you. You're gonna stand. We're gonna do a one-legged adductor squat. One leg comes out to the ball. Place it on the center of that ball. Steady it. Bring your body upright. Dumbbell to the outside hand. The modifier on this, we'll do it without the dumbbell. It's a little easier. It's hard to work up here. Stabilizing on the ball, making the muscles fire differently on the adductors, the inner thigh of that leg, not to mention your balance from this leg. One hand to the hip, you're gonna lower it down like this and drive up. It's active, not passive, so take charge of the move. Do them with me. Only go as low as you can go without compromising the form. One time, perfect. Come around to the other side. Switch hands with the dumbbell. Abs are in, foot is up, hands on the hip, chest up, chin up, control the descent. Let's do them. Breathing. Two times. Perfect. Walk it in. Put the dumbbell down. We're going to our core move, which is an abdominal move, but you're doing them in the frontal plane, not the sagittal plane, front to back. So side to side like a windshield wiper. Sit on the ball, side saddle. Walk it down comfortably. Bottom foot goes forward. Bottom arm goes across the chest. Top arm down the leg. You're gonna crunch up this way. That's what it looks like. That hand will go down the leg towards the ankle. The modifier is gonna put the bottom leg on the floor to make it a little easier, then she'll work her way up. Here we go, guys, do them with me. Up, up, perfect. Nice tight crunch, pulling the abs in as you do them. So much more fun being on the ball too, because it's always challenging. You can't zone out when you're doing your exercises. Last four, crunch, 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 keep crunching. Perfect. Walk it up. Walk around. Other side, you're seated. Then walk it out. Bottom arm on the ball. Hand across the chest. Bottom leg forward. Top hand down the leg. You'll crunch up. Reach towards that ankle. Keep it neat. Keep it strong. Let's do them. Make it happen. This is active. It's not gonna work if you're not working. Last six, abs in. Two times. Perfect. Walking it up. That was great. We're moving on. You're seated nice and tall on this ball in total control, abs in, should be very comfortable by now. Reaching across, take one of the dumbbells, take it inside that opposite leg and take this hand and bring it to the back. Palm is up so you resist any potential cheating. You're gonna do a modified Olympic move here. This is a snatch, it's one move up but two down. As you get to the top of the move, lock it and stick the landing. Picture a gymnast owning that landing. So here it looks like this, you'll come from here, one move up, down and over. Make sure you do it in a controlled fashion. Remember, you're on an unstable surface. That's why you're getting so much more bang for the buck working on this ball instead of on a bench. Here we go, do them with me. Controlled. It's one up, down and return. Perfect. Breathing. Strong and ballistic on the way up, people. You own these. Last one. Bang, to the top and to the bottom. Slide the weight over, switching hands. That's a great windmill move there. Here we go, other side, do them. Stick it, down, and return. Stick it, down, and return. Feel them, abs are in. Make sure you keep breathing. This is a big move here, big core move as well. Last two, bang. Perfect, down. And return it, dumbbell goes back. We're moving to our lower body move to keep that blood shunting. Upper body, lower body. Hands are gonna go on the legs. To modify this, because this involves a little bit of balance, you can put the hands on the side. We're going to a leg extension here. So lift one leg, find your balance before you begin, and we're gonna do four different moves within the set. The modification would also be to not keep the leg up all the way through the set. You could touch it down on the floor in between reps. So to begin, we have a neutral foot and it goes out and squeezes, flush the quad, that's the muscle on the top of the leg. Get it nice and hard, nice and strong, and then bring it back. Here we go, do these with me. Four, three, two, one, and hold it out. Now turn the toe in, bring it back. Four, three, those are great. Two, and one, hold it. Turn it all the way out now. Down, keep balancing, keep working. You're on the ball for a reason. Two, one, hold it. Now long pointed toe, bring it back. Reach, reach, keep the body upright. Beautiful. Down, let it rest on the floor. Don't drop it. Rest, control. You own this, guys. You're all over it. One other leg coming up. Neutral foot, abs are in. Nice tall body. Reach out, reach out. Perfect. All the way out, turn it. Remember, if you want to modify, just like Michelle's doing, you can let the foot touch in between reps, and you can hold that ball on the side. Perfect, turn it all the way out. Four, three, two, and one. Long pointed leg, reach with it. Tense it, make it work, keep it strong. Easy, put it down, controlled. Reach over and grab your dumbbells. We're going to the upper body move now, which is a shoulder move. We're gonna do them one arm at a time so we enhance the dynamic portion of this movement. Little bend at the elbow. You're gonna go out to the side. It's a lateral raise, and then it comes down. To modify this, Michelle will bend her arm a little bit more. Remember, think about lifting the upper arm from shoulder to elbow, not the lower arm. The lower arm is gonna trail the upper arm. Here we go. Do them with me. Raise it. Graze the ball, raise, graze. Perfect, light on the grip. Don't waste any energy squeezing. Three times, when you're at the top, try to dip it slightly so the index finger is a little bit lower than the pinky. Perfect, bring it down, let it rest. Other side, a little bend at the elbow. Here we go, people. Up, up, raise and graze. That's what I need you to think about. Abs in tight, your weight is over the ball here. It's not out in your feet. Four, three, two, and one. That was great. Now bring the dumbbells to your legs. We're gonna do our core move here. Abdominals working. The modifier will be to do them without the weights. Perfect. Now walk it all the way down. Bringing the weights up to your collarbone. This is your crunch, sagittal plane, traditional front to back, abs are in, weights in your heels. The ball should be at about mid back to upper back. Remember, just getting down here, just being on this, your body is working to keep you balanced. So challenge it now, coming up and dropping back. That's what it looks like. Do them with me, guys. Up, up, great. Belly button pulls in as you come up. Always enough room under your chin to put that dumbbell so you don't block your breathing passage. I need six, five, four, three, two, and one. Perfect. Walk it up. That was great. You're not gonna need the dumbbells for this next move, so go ahead and put them off to the side. Coming around the ball. You're going to do a modified reverse hyperextension here. You're on the ball, so it's already dynamic. Abs are in. Walk it all the way down. Nice and safe, nice and controlled. Long legs, turn the toes out slightly. Hands should be slightly forward of the shoulders. Drop the shoulders down. No co-contraction up there. The modification on this move is going to be Michelle to my right, who's going to let her feet come down and touch the floor in between repetitions. We're not going to do it that way. We're going to keep controlled tension all the way through. So it looks like this one is done. Raise and lower. Abs in. Nice, steady breathing. Do them with me, people. Up. Up. Don't let it drift forward. Abs are stabilized here. Your core is working the entire time here. Steady with your breathing. Pick a spot on the floor slightly forward of your hands to look at. Last two. Up squeeze. Up squeeze. Perfect. Now roll it back nice and easy, coming to your knees. Your next move is also going to be forward, but that's a lot of compression on the abs, so I want you to be able to soften, collect yourself. Coming out now to the ball. Commit your weight there. Nice long legs. Hands go back, top of the glutes. You want the ball to be at about hip level, waist level. If you had a belt on, you'd be driving forward with your belly button. This move looks like that. It's a hyperextension coming up that way. You're working the muscles of the lower back. You're not risking injury. In fact, you're preventing yourself from an injury. And by being on the ball and stabilizing, you're recruiting from all the way around the core. Michelle's going to do this a little modified. She'll be on her knees. You can work your way up to where we are. Here we go. Join in with me. Up and squeeze, coming down. Up and squeeze, coming down. Now standing just like that. Make it active, not passive. So you control it, come down. Control it. Nice, people. These are great. Chin is up. These are great. Two times. Lower it. Don't drop it. One time. Great. Outstanding. Walk it back. Onto the knees. Shoulders are down. Nice and soft. The next move is going to be also all the way out. I want you to get that under control with the breathing. Now take it forward. Go into a plank position where your forearms are down. Take your fingers out straight so you don't get tempted to co-contract here. That's what normally happens. It's your body's anticipation of pain. It ends up working out and using a lot of wasted energy. So the fingers are straight here. Your legs are long. Toes point and pull back. You're going to raise one leg. Bring it down, then raise the other. It's an alternating leg lift from the plank position. Do them with me. Up and squeeze. Up and squeeze. Nice long legs. Press that heel towards the ceiling. Try not to let your weight shift forward. Breathing steady. No turtles. I don't want to see the neck here. I want you long, lean. Perfect. The modification on this would be to be on your hands the way Michelle's doing, and letting the feet touch down in between repetitions. These are great. Last four, knock them out with me. One, two, three, and four. Sliding back, you've earned it. We're going to our core move now. You're seated, one foot on either side of the ball, holding the ball. Make sure your breathing's under control. I want you to lean back just enough to feel the abs engage. If you're sitting up here, you're probably going to be resting and not working them. I want you back nice and tight. Hold the ball. You're going to rotate the ball side to side, touching, and then to the other side, touching. You're working in the transverse plane. You work there every day, so you've got to train there so you don't get injured there. Michelle's going to do this in a modified version by keeping the ball relatively tight to her body, but she'll still be seeing where she's putting it. Reach over and reach back. That's what it looks like. Do them with me, guys. Touch, touch, touch. Perfect. Abs pull in as you pass that center line. These are good. Wind them up. See it. Last one. Back to center. That was great. We're moving on. The next move is a hip bridge with a rollout. You're going to rock all the way back to the floor. Bring your feet up on top of the ball. Now pull the ball in towards you. Hands out to your side. Heels in contact with the ball. The modifier will be Michelle to my right. And she's going to have her calves on the ball from the start. You're gonna drive up at the hip and then press out, abs pulling in, reel it back in and lower it down. Hamstrings working, glutes and hips are working, and of course the abs are working just by being on this ball. Here we go, do them with me. Up and drive, easy back. Up and drive, easy back. Perfect. Abs pulling in, drive the belt buckle to the ceiling. I need three more. And reel it in, slowly lower it down. We're gonna move on to a single leg press here. I need one foot on the ball, the other foot straight up in the air. We're gonna drive down, pressing the foot that's on the ball into it, and then lower control. Working the hamstring and the glutes, and of course, stabilizing by being on the ball. The modification on this will be to keep the leg that we have up in the air down on the ball with the calf in contact with it. Michelle's got that covered. Here we go, do them with me. Up, up. It's an active press through the ball. Make it happen. Don't wait for it to happen. Three times. You got these. And you're down. Switching feet. The other foot goes to the ball. The leg that just worked is straight up in the air. Michelle's got it down on the calf. Here we go, abs in, drive. Drive, it's an active press right through that ball. Try to pop it. Take over, take control. One time, and you're down. Perfect, feet on the sides of the ball. You're coming up just enough to get those weights. We're going to our upper body move, which is a tricep move, working the muscles on the backs of the arms. Feet are up on the ball, hands straight up, parallel grip. Slide it back slightly so the triceps stay engaged. You're gonna lower the weight now behind your head and then bring it back up and rotate it so the tricep remains engaged. Don't let them come all the way straight here. I want you to stay working. Parallel grip, angled slightly. Do them with me. Feet are on the ball to make sure the core stays working. Just by stabilizing. Those are good. I need six more. Finish with me. Last one. Nice. Now lower it. Control. Take it out wider than your shoulders. Maintaining a grip on the dumbbells. You're using them as an anchor now. This is your abdominal move, your core move. Taking the ball between the feet, you're gonna raise it straight up, and then we're gonna go side to side doing a little Russian twist. It's up here, you'll go to one side, back to center, then to the other side, back to center. No pause in the middle, make them steady. Only go as low as you can go while maintaining control. Do them with me. Down, down. Those are nice, they're hard to do, but I know you're working at it. Pull the abs in as you lower the ball. Two times. Perfect, lower the ball. One foot on either side. Dumbbells go to your chest, then to your hips, so it's safely done as you come up. That's a nice job, we're moving on. Our next move is a bicep curl. I need you to stand up, grab your dumbbells, and come around and have a seat on the ball. Chest is up nice and tall, palms forward. Now take them out to the sides. Abs are in, your weight is centered over that ball, very light on the feet. Strong curl to the top, and then lower it down. Make sure your wrist is either towards you or straight, but not broken back, because that'll engage too much forearm. Here we go, do them with me. Up and squeeze. Upper arm stays tight to the upper body. Squeezing, squeezing. Nice, people, nice. Last four, knock them out. And slowly lower the weight, turn the palms back. You're gonna go into a bent over lateral raise, working the rear head of the shoulder. The front head of that shoulder gets a lot of work on all your pressing movements. This is going to get it by itself. Palms down. They're facing in. The dumbbells are parallel to your shoes. Your weight is in your heels and on the ball. You're going to raise out to the side, slowly lower it down. By being on the ball, you're still getting more core work than you would on a bench, which means you're getting more benefits. Here we go. Take them out to the side. Do them with me. Up. Up. Just like that. No turtlenecking. Keep the shoulders out of the ears. Lower it with control. They're good. I need two. Perfect. Lower them. Dumbbells go off to the side. You're coming up. Your next move is a lower body move, but it's three moves in one. It's a butt devil. So you can do a reaching lunge where you step forward, bending at the waist, tag the ball, drive back up, alternate legs, tag, come back up. You'll do eight of those. Then you're going to do a side lunge where you step out to the side, reach out here, touch the ball, come back up. It's dynamic, ballistic, push off, make it active. Then the other side, you're back. Then you're going to do a twisting lunge where you reach back, let the front foot pivot, tag the ball, come back up to center, other foot goes next, tag, and back up. Eight of each, I'll remind you along the way. Jump in, reaching lunge, here we go. And up. And up. Perfect. Let your body decelerate, that's part of your work. Two times. One time. Nice, up top, dropping the shoulders, collect yourself, find your breathing. Stepping out to the side, side lunge, here we go. Tag, tag, reach outside the foot, go as low as you can go comfortably and safely while maintaining your form. Two times, and back to center, soften, here we go again, twisting lunge, knock these out. Let the front foot pivot, drive off the foot that stepped back. Two times. And you're back. Those are great. Now we're going to our core move, putting the ball down. Walk around, have a seat. You're going to ease down on the ball. Lower back is where you'll feel that. Bring your toes up just a little, drive the weight into the heels. Hands crossing. You're going to do a regular crunch, but once you get to the top, you're going to rotate to one side, then rotate to the other. That's the side I'm going to. You go with me. Up top, one, two, down. One, two, down. That's great. Working. Good. Distinct at the top. Perfect. Two times. And walk it up. Control it, balance on the ball. That was great. We're moving on. Our first move is going to be a dumbbell front raise. So reach over, grab your dumbbells. Bring them up, come up nice and tall on the ball. Center your weight over the ball. Don't let it drift too far forward. This way you're working, you're stabilizing, your abs are already engaged doing a shoulder move. Palms back, chest up, chin up, little bend at the elbows. You're gonna raise it up top right here at about eyebrow level, slight dip when you're out, and then all the way back. Here we go, do them with me. Up, and it's down. It's controlled, it's a lift, not a throw. See them, make them happen. Up and down. Perfect. Nice high head, nice high chest. Three coming up. One time. Bringing them down, that's great. Now bring the dumbbells to your hips. You're going to a lower body move. It's a hip kip. The modification on this will be to put the dumbbells off to the side. That's what Michelle's gonna do. Walk it down easy. Abs in. Put the ball below the center of your back. Let your head rock back onto the ball so there's no strain on the neck. Your heels are bearing most of the weight for the feet. Your hips are sinking nice and low, just a couple inches off the ground. From there, you're gonna drive it up. Abs are in tight. Belly button pulls in tight. You're driving your belt buckle to the ceiling, and then you're gonna lower it down under control. Here we go, do them with me. Strong drive up, slowly back. Drive and slowly. Abs in, don't drop it and hope. Make it happen, you're in control. Stay with me. Wiggle the toes. Make sure they're not squunched up in your shoe. That's another form of a co-contraction. Last two. One time. Perfect. Bring it down. Walk it back up. That was great. Dumbbells are going to go off to the side. You're going to come around the ball. Seat it on the floor. One foot on either side of the ball. Now take the ball up and overhead. We're gonna do a ball pass, hands to feet, and then feet to hands. So you'll do, it's a jackknife type move. You're gonna come up, pass the ball from the hands to the feet, bring it down slowly, working the negative portion or the eccentric portion, which is the lowering, and then bring it back up and change that way. You're passing the ball to yourself. Here we go, do them with me. Up. Up, slowly on the way down, control it. The modification on these would be to do them with the ball between the knees, not quite as far out. They're great, people. Last two. And you're down. Next move is a wood chop from the lying position. You're gonna do five to one side, then five to the other, then finish with five to center. So slide the ball over to one side just a little bit. You're gonna come up in a chopping move, lowering slowly, focusing on that negative part of the lift, bringing it just outside the opposite knee. So you'll come up, chop, abs pull in, rib cage crunches down towards the hip, and then bring it back this way. Here we go, five times, do them with me. Squeeze, slowly back. Squeeze, nice long arms, let the body open up. Squeeze, squeeze, they're good. And you're down, now shift it to the other side. Recenter your body, we're going to the opposite knee, abs pull in, crunch, long arms back. Crunch, long arms back, they're good. Two times, one time. Perfect, coming back, bring it to center, finish up. The modifier on this is just going to the knees. If that's what you can do, that's what you can do. You still get credit. It's great ab work, great oblique work, which are the muscles along the side of the abdominal wall. Here we go to center, last five, finish strong. Five, reach, five, slowly open up, curl it back. One time, long on the way back. Let it rest. Bring the ball up to center. You're coming up. You did a great job. We're gonna move on. You've just finished some really challenging exercises, so let's stretch it out. I need one hand on top of the ball, the other hand behind you. Long reach, abs in, open up the upper back. Steady your breathing in through the nose to a three count. Take the air down, little hold. Steady with the exhale from the mouth, same three count. That's perfect. Wind it around, switching hands. Reach back. Chin stays high so it's not blocking the breathing passage. Perfect. Coming back around, we're gonna switch hands again. Reach behind you to stretch. This time, dropping the knees and rolling the hips over. Long torso, lean torso, abs pull in. Rocking back enough to feel this stretch. Come all the way down to your hip flexor. Hip flexors tend to tighten up during the day, especially if there's a lot of sitting or a lot of driving involved in your day. That's great. Bring it around the other side. Switching hands, knees down, hips roll around. Perfect. Bring it back to center. Coming up to a modified cat stretch. I need you on your knees. Hands on the center of the ball. Let your hips rock back on your heels. Steady exhale. Lower the chest down towards the floor. When you're down there, don't let your chin drop. Make sure your breathing is controlled. And release it into the stretch. Curl it up now, rounding the back. Bring the ball in a little bit. We're gonna roll it over to one side. Both hands center on the ball. The ball's about shoulder level. Lower the body. Outside arm at the tricep, the back of that arm driving towards the floor to accentuate the stretch through the rear shoulder, down the lats, which are your back muscles up top, and all the way down to the waist. Still breathing when you're down there. Perfect, come up, roll it around to the other side. Even with the shoulders, both hands on top. Ease it down, outside hands your leader. That's great work. Come up to center, keep that one hand out on the ball, the back hand. The other hand comes down, a little wider than your shoulders, a little bend at the elbow. Ease the chest towards the floor with the palm flat. Opening up the front shoulder and the chest on that side. Now come up, turn the hand down, index finger on the ball. Locking that arm, control the stretch, pushing down from the inside of the elbow towards the floor. You feel the stretch in the bicep, hard to stretch area, but effective here on the ball. And in the forearm. Bring it up, roll it to the other side. You guys work hard today, you deserve the stretch. You need the stretch, take it out. This hand outside, elbow bends, ease the chest down. Come up, roll the hand over, index finger on the ball, stretching down the bicep, forearm. Perfect, bring it up to center, ball goes in front of you. You're gonna rest your body weight on the ball. One more time, roll it forward. This is called a drape, where you let your body just rest on the ball. Hands are outstretched, they're in front of the shoulders, a little wider than shoulder width. Feet are out, not a lot of weight in the hands, not a lot of weight in the feet. Commit to the ball, exhale, ease into it. Bring one foot up, lock that leg out, hands come back a little. Drive the weight back into that heel. Nice stretch in the calf, beginning to stretch in the hamstring. We'll get there. Perfect, coming up other side, switch it. Drive back, heel towards the floor. Back to center, both feet. This time as you drive back, let the hips come up slowly. Heels go down, legs are locked. Nice stretch in the hamstring. Great work, guys. And ease it back, hips coming down to the heels. Come up nice and tall, dropping the shoulders. Big inhale, big exhale. You did a great job. You just finished the accelerated workout. It's a lot of dynamic work here done on the ball. Your core is challenged throughout the work, and the benefits you get by working on this ball are not only a better shaped body, but increased strength, increased stamina, and a better quality of life. Give yourself credit for the work you've done. You are well on your way to achieving your fitness goals. Stick with it. You did a terrific job.